friends, Heidi here from Rain Country. God is good all the time. And today I'm going to be talking about clothing, new versus used versus homemade. So we're going to be talking about what are the best ways to save but also get high quality when it comes to your clothing, because you want things that are going to last, but you also want things that are going to suit you, your body style, your needs, your day-to-day needs, how you work, where you work, and so on and so forth. Let's talk first about just the idea of coming up with your own style, because I think when you can come up with your own style, not only do you get to tailor that to suit your needs, you're also going to be saving money, because when you do that, you're not trying to fit in to what society standards are of clothing. For me, one of those things was trying to find clothing that was easy to move in, that was comfortable, but also modest, and I could also feel pretty. And so for me, I started making my own skirts, and I have different types of skirts. You know, this is not what I would call a work skirt. This is going to be a skirt that's going to be nicer for wearing out and about. But I'll get to more of that later. So my style is going to be probably quite different than most people. And that's fine. I'm totally cool with that. I like my style. It's me. It suits me all the way around. In my ability to be mobile and to do all the things that I need to do, even climbing ladders, yes, in a skirt, and working out in the garden, and even mucking out the chicken coop. I do all of these things in a skirt. That's my personal choice, and it's what works for me. Now you have to decide what works best for you. But now let's get on to how do I go about finding the best way that I can save money on clothes as well as also having high quality. So there's so many different ways that you can go about this. So a lot of you know, a lot of my clothes that I wear are homemade, but not all of them. Mostly the things that I wear that I make myself are all of my skirts and my leggings. Those I make all myself, even my support tops that I wear under my shirts. I make all these by hand. So these are all homemade. I do this because for several reasons. It saves me money. I can easily tailor these things to fit me and my shape, and I can also get good quality. So I get, by doing that myself, I can do all of those things with that. The other thing I make from time to time are shirts, just like the one that I'm wearing, this one here, not the button-down shirt, but this shirt here. When I have extra material of any kind, so this particular one here, this is a thermal knit. This is the fabric I like to buy for making my leggings out of. And when I have enough left over, I'll use that same fabric for making support tops. So I've made, and those ones are the most comfortable yet, the ones I've made out of the thermal knit. And t-shirts are, it's not really a t-shirt, it's more of a shell, just a basic shirt that's super duper easy to throw together, but it's quality and it's comfortable. I love this shirt. You've probably been seeing me wear it a lot in recent videos because I made it just recently, and I love it. It's a very simple pattern. I have a video on how you can do this. I don't even use a pattern, and I will go ahead and link to that video in the description box down below, as well as some other videos like how you can make your own support top. You'll be able to find all those in the description box. So again, hit show more or that little arrow if you're on the Android device or other smart device where it may not show the show more. It may just show a little arrow. So that will drop down that description box so you can see all our links in there. But here's the other thing about the tops, about making my own. Though I love making my own, and I do find them to be some of my very favorite ones, are the ones I make myself, they're not always the most frugal way to go about it. When it comes to tops, whether it be button-down tops, t-shirts, flannel shirts, pretty much all the ones you see me wear, I have bought secondhand. And so that would be a shirt like this one here. So a t-shirt that I paid a whole dollar for. I don't care if this brand's still popular or not. I don't care. I liked the color and it was cheap. And then this shirt that I'm wearing here, which I really, really like, I think I paid $2 for at a garage sale, and I don't even know if it had ever even been worn. It's like brand new. And I just really like this color, and it fits nicely. It's very comfortable, It's a great shirt to work in or to dress it up a little nicer and wear it out and about if I want to. Pretty much every flannel shirt you see me wear, I've paid anywhere from 50 cents to $2 for at garage sales. And most of the t-shirts you see me wear, I've bought at garage sales. So when it comes to tops, it is actually more frugally sound to buy them secondhand. However, there are times where buying brand new isn't so bad either, such as this t-shirt here. I think I paid $5 for this one brand new. Now, for me to buy the fabric to make a shirt like this, it's gonna be more than $5. For just the enough fabric to make a shirt like this, it's gonna probably be anywhere from $6 to $10. So it's actually cheaper for me to buy a t-shirt like this brand new, even though I haven't done that in years. This shirt is quite a few years old. I love this shirt, but really, some of my most favorite tops are the ones that I have bought at garage sales. So really secondhand when it comes to being frugal is with your clothing is the best way to go. But when it comes to certain styles, such as my skirts, I'm not gonna find anything like this at a garage sale. But what I have found at garage sales are lots and lots of fabrics for making patchwork skirts. So I'm gonna show you a picture right here of a skirt that I have and I've made myself. I made one like it and sold it, and then another one I made for myself. This particular skirt is made entirely from all garage sale find fabrics. So it's the, as far as cost that was involved, that was the least expensive skirt that I've ever had to make. And where this one has a mix of garage sale fine fabrics like this one here, of brand new fabrics like this one here, and then fabrics like this one that I didn't pay anything for. This fabric right here was from my mom. So after she passed away and we went and cleaned out her house, this was actually her bedroom curtains. But also that's why I had to make at least one of these skirts for myself, because this print right here is so my mom, the colors and everything about it. And so I had to have a skirt with this fabric in it. But anyway, so this is a blend of new and used fabrics. Some didn't cost me anything, some cost me very little, and some cost me as much as $10 a yard. So making your own patchwork skirt, if you're buying your fabrics new, is not the cheap way to go. But you can make either a patchwork skirt or just a solid skirt, like one of my very early videos of making the frontier skirt with just the solid brown. And it was made entirely from a sheet that I paid 50 cents for at a garage sale. So when it comes to that, if you can find fabric at a garage sale for really cheap like that and then make your own clothes, that's just going to be the most frugal way to go. And I love doing that. I do that a lot. Now, another thing that I like to make for myself, and it saves me quite a bit of money, is when I want dressier looking sweaters, like this one that I have here, which I actually haven't worn in a very long time. And I'll actually show you a picture of myself wearing it right here so you can get a better look of it. But it has a very Asian style to it with the sleeves. The sleeves are kind of interesting because they're slit up the inside. But anyway, it's just a beautiful sweater. Now, it's not cheap to buy the yarn, but the price I paid for the yarn, there's no way I could find a sweater like this store-bought or somebody else made for as little as what I paid for the yarn itself. And then I did the work. Now, if I was to make this same sweater for someone else, I would have to charge for my time, for the hours and hours of work that went into that. So if you're thinking of buying sweaters, having somebody hand make you sweaters and you're going to pay them for it and think you're going to save money because of the cost of yarn, be fair, people, because there's hours of work that goes into that. You're likely going to pay a lot more for a local handmade sweater than you are for some cheap sweater you can buy at Walmart. But to make a beautiful sweater like this and some of these other ones I'm going to show you in these pictures here, for me to make it myself, yes, it saves me a lot of money because I can make a unique sweater that nobody else has that suits my style and my needs, and it's not going to cost me very much. But for me to make something for someone, I got to make it worth my time, and just like anyone else. I mean, a lot of people, when we handcraft sweaters, we might only be getting paid $2 an hour. And how many of you are willing to work for $2 an hour? So if you can't crochet your own sweaters, then or knit your own sweaters, then you probably are better off buying those at a store, you know, but you also have to consider quality. So that comes into play too. So even a brand like this, and yes, even American Eagle, these are all made in China. American Eagle clothes are made in China. Don't let the name fool you. So if having clothes made in your own country is important to you, you need to look at where they're actually made. A lot of things might have a flag on them, American flag, or American in the name, in the title. That does not mean they're American made. In fact, most of them are not. It can actually be quite difficult to find American made clothes. But if you can't sew or crochet or knit your own clothes, I am gonna recommend a place that I found years ago that has high quality clothes. And this is specifically, of course, gonna be for people who are Americans that wanna buy American made clothes. I'm gonna go ahead and put that link down below. I've bought several clothes back when I still wore jeans. I've bought jeans from them. All the cotton was actually grown here in America, and the jeans were made here in America, and they actually had a pretty good price for their just basic jeans. Again, though, keep in mind, when you're talking American-made clothes, they are going to be more expensive than the ones you get in China, that are made in China. But they're also going to be higher quality. So this shirt here, as much as I like this shirt, and it was, you know, I wouldn't pay more than $5 for this shirt. That's the most I'd ever pay. In fact, again, I don't even do that anymore because I just look for shirts at garage sales. These are both the same brand, both China made, but I can tell by the feel of the fabric, they're definitely lower quality. So I still like them and I'll still wear them, and they were still worth the cost I paid, but I could make a higher quality item here. But if I really wanted a high quality shirt that I wasn't going to make myself, then I've bought them at that place. I think it's called American Clothing or something like that. I can't remember, but anyway, again, I'll put that link down below. Last I looked, they're carrying more and more American made items, including Carhartt. Here's something you need to know about Carhartt. Not all of their items are made in America. Most likely the ones in your local store are made either in Mexico or I can't remember the other country. There's another country that they're made in. And a lot of them are made in Mexico. A lot of them are made overseas somewhere else. But there are those that are made in America, and you can find those particular ones, and they're not really that much more than the ones that are made overseas or out of the country at that same website that I'll be linking down below. So really, when it comes right down to it, oh yes, and Mini Me is here too, and her clothes are all handmade as well. Not by me, but by the lady that made this doll for me. When it comes to figuring out what's the best way you can save money as well as get quality, it's going to depend again on your needs, what you do in those clothes. And you know, for me, I don't mind wearing like a t-shirt. I don't mind having a cheaper quality t-shirt for certain things, especially for working around the house. But for higher quality, like this, I think is a higher quality shirt, but I still only paid $2 for it at a garage sale. So for when it comes to tops, those are my top place to go. But when it comes to leggings and support tops and skirts and sweaters, these are all things I'm gonna make myself. It's gonna cost me more to make them myself than it would be to buy them, but I like the fact that I can make them in my own style and also to fit me the way I want them to fit me, and also out of the fabrics I want, such as leggings. It's hard to find good quality leggings that don't have spandex and that kind of stuff in it. I prefer not to have that. I want 100% cotton. And if I can get 100% organic cotton, then I do that too. Like the black thermal knit leggings I've made for myself, those are made out of organic, a 100% cotton fabric. And they are so comfortable and very warm in the winter time. So anyway, I just wanted to present a few different ideas out there for you. If you're a DIY person, making your own stuff can save you a lot of money, but not in all areas. You got to balance it out. You got to kind of play all the fields and according to your needs. Now, some of you might be better off making your own shirts, but buying your pants and stuff at garage sales or your skirts, depending on what it is, what your style is, and what you can find in your local area. Oh, and if you're interested in my crochet videos, I don't have any showing how I make these sweaters. All of my sweater patterns, though I do make a lot of patterns of my own, like when it comes to hats and little amigurumi, the little stuffed characters, I can show you some pictures of here. A lot of those are patterns I've come up with myself. But when it comes to the handmade sweaters, these patterns I found, like this particular one here, all of them I have found for free online. Like you can go to the Lion Brand site and they have a lot of free patterns at their site. You can go to Ravelry.com and sign up there. And some of the patterns they have in there you have to purchase, but some of them, there's quite a bit you can find for free. So a lot of times what I do, if you're a crocheter or a knitter, all you have to do is put in, this is how I found all these patterns, is I put into my browser free crochet sweater patterns, and then I found all kinds of stuff. And so you can get free patterns by going that route if you want. And so if you're already doing that, that's great. And if you want to learn how to crochet, I do actually have a series out that teaches all the basics plus a few of the simple patterns, like how to make skillet handle covers and various things like that that you can check out if you're interested. But anyway, it's basically the 101 series and just shows you the basics to get started. And once you understand those basics and how to read patterns, then you can start making sweaters like this. Like this sweater right here has a lot of treble crochets and chain stitches. Very, as complicated as that may look, it's actually very simple stitches right here. Okay, so I hope you found this a little bit helpful and kind of get you thinking about your needs. And again, don't forget the whole idea of just coming up with your own style and getting outside of what the social norms are. It doesn't, you don't have to look like everyone else. In fact, what is the fun in that anyway of looking like everyone else? Why not be individual? Why not be unique? Come up with your own style that suits you, something that you like, that you feel good in, but you can also work in and get your stuff done in, and just, you know, actually enjoy wearing those clothes. Like me, I've always hated jeans. I've always hated wearing jeans, even though I have worn them. They've only been something I'd wear when I'm going out because I hate them. I don't like to work in them. Ugh, no, I just never, ever have. I've always been that way. So finally I thought, why am I even bothering with jeans? I'm just gonna start wearing comfy, pretty skirts and I can feel good about myself and still get my stuff done and be comfortable. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video and it just gave you a few ideas of maybe reevaluating your wardrobe and reconsidering how you think when it comes to frugality. Because sometimes making your own clothes isn't the most frugal way to go, but it may be the best way for you to fit your style and the quality that you're looking for. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed this video and I'd sure love to hear your thoughts down below, especially if you have any unique ideas when it comes to clothing and what works for you. So thanks for watching. Take care and God bless.